What's up, guys? It's David here again, AnyVault. I'm going to be taking a little bit of a break from doing reaction videos for a while so I can focus on my music for a while. So if you've got any suggestions, I'll do them in a few days or maybe next week or maybe something like that. I just thought I'd quickly react to this one to let you know what's going on anyway. So this one is Goddamn. I don't know how you pronounce it, but I know the song because it's one of my favourites by Alice in Chains. This is live, 1986 Lane's last show. It's got quite a few views as well. It's got like 1.7 million, I think. So yeah, let's do it, innit? I haven't got much to say. Quick thing as well before it kicks in, I did react to Man in the Box from Lane's last show as well. I know a lot of people don't like to watch Lane's last years, but if you do are interested in watching it, then it's on my channel, so check it out. Welcome back to any returning subscribers or any new ones. I'm David. Rewind that back as well, man. Love that. It means that. Sounds amazing. Can you be as God is? Can I be as my God is? God of all my God is. You know what I get from this? The vibe I get from this song is that I didn't like to say it, but I said it in the Man in the Boxing as well. I think this full show, you must have like knew something was going to happen, because obviously not long after the show he overdosed, but he must have knew something was going to end, not his life, because he lived another fucking another 6 years after that, man. But I think he, in my opinion, like the way he was singing on the last show, this last show, in a way he kind of knew, if you know what I mean, like, if I'm going to go out, I need to give it me all again. And he always did anyway, I'm not saying he ever didn't, but this vibe on this song is completely different. Like, pure anger, pure disdain for what's happened and stuff. Like, I can feel it, you know what I mean? I can feel it in his voice when he's singing the chorus, and even this song, even just singing it through the verse. But when you hear the chorus again, which I assume is going to be coming up soon, it's like he knew in his head, and all that shit he's been dealing with, he's let it out in the song, you know what I mean? Like, all that shit was on the plate there, because obviously look what happened to him. And I think this song resembles how much anger he has for himself and how hurt he is because of the way life has went down for him, you know what I mean? That's my opinion, though. So now I see you grinning. Must be grand, always winning.
Can you be
I'm not even like, I'm not even lying here. Like, he makes me feel upset. Like, this upsets me. You know what I mean? I don't know if it upsets anybody else, but like, hearing him sing that song, like, I don't mean, I'm not even an emotional guy, but like, I feel it in my heart. Like, right now, it's fucking killing us, you know what I mean? And that's why I love Liam. Quick thing, I'm gonna rewind it as well. Just that last line. That sick one, Joe. Can't hide sick one, Joe Weed, nothing. Hang on. Yeah, that can't hide sick one, Joe Weed, man. That speaks volumes to me, man. Like, but anyway, back on the track, let me finish it. Wow. I don't know what to say. Pitch perfect as always, pitch perfect, but I get a completely different vibe off that, guys, and I've took my headphones off so I can actually hear myself speak because I thought it's dead annoying when I've got muffled sound when I'm trying to speak. But that's all I can say. He was pitch perfect, but he's just got this way of getting in my head, mate. Like everybody, I was gonna say mate, like I'm talking to someone, but it's true, like he's got a way of getting in your head. Like, I can't describe it. Like it hurts me heart hearing that performance because he means everything he says in it, and all the lines I was reading, everything I was hearing, like all made sense of what he was going through in that time as well. Like 90, in the mid-90s, he wasn't in a good frame of mind. He wasn't feeling good. He wasn't in a good place, and obviously the physicals were starting to show as well, but. For him to be that fragile, because he was like, in my opinion, when I look at him, a fragile kind of person. Like he wasn't an explosive guy. Like obviously he was when he's singing. That's where the one thing that was his golden ticket. You know what I mean? His that voice you can resonate everywhere. But in terms of him as a person, he didn't seem like one of them that were like confrontational and very violent. And he was more of a feeler, in my opinion. And he reminds us of me, like hearing the way he speaks in interviews and stuff like that, and I don't know, I just get this free, I link with him. I don't even know him. You know what I mean? Do you get what I'm saying, guys? Like, I link with him, and I don't even know the kid. Like, everything he sings, I feel in my heart. Like, I can't describe it, but that's the beautiful thing about him, and the beautiful thing about his voice, and the way he was as a person, man. But anyway, that's me done. That's my general honest opinions on it. It does hurt me heart. But anyway. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Sorry if it's a down note, but you know, this is one of them, innit? Yeah, let us know if you want to react to anything else. It won't be happening soon. It'll be happening probably next week or something because I need to take a break and just get me head straight. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. This is IDH, David of AnyVault. Bye bye.